Yeah, one more time and I would have bought it. If you got a...
All right, but it's not like the sort of music that you were making.
No, I mean the stuff that they're playing on the radio now is dance music, and you really do listen to the radio.
What
you
about
don't
this?
Dance to it.
What about this?
That was okay. It was, you know...
We were doing it on early albums, some of that stuff.
Wait a minute. Some people don't agree with it. Who doesn't agree? Right, what do you think?
Don't mind me saying so, it was bloody awful. You couldn't understand the lyrics, you couldn't understand the tune. The Troggs, give me any
60s.
Day.
Right.
Okay, just a second, let me just put these points to the musicians themselves. No, don't run away, you've got lots of fans here. Does it matter that you can't hear
the
words?
I can't say anything though, I don't think I've...
Well, does it matter that you can't hear the words?
I think you can hear the words, I can hear the words.
You were closer than the rest of us. You were singing them. I mean, you deliberately put noises on the tracks, you know, musical roars and things like that.
It's noisy, but then, you know, life's noisy, isn't it?
So this is a kind of music that is like life in that sense.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, it's a...
You think that?
Reflection of life.
Do you think so?
Esther, the lady over there has had 30 years to listen to the Troggs music. This is only the second time, or maybe third time, she's heard it. Now, once she gets to hear the wedding present a little bit more, she'll really enjoy it.
Oh, all right, all right. Wait a minute. You are going to like this much, much more if you hear it over and over again.
Never in a million years. I think the drummer was quite good, but the lyrics and the... Never in a million years. You'd never. No,
that reaction,
drove me mad.
That reaction,
Tony, yes.
The reaction there is what the mums and dads were saying about the Rolling Stones in the 60s.
Is it?
No, but I mean, it's a
is
matter
it?
Of. No, it, no, yes, but you were saying it's brilliant, but your mum was probably saying, oh, no, dreadful noise. So it's the same reaction. It's a matter of getting older, isn't it?
It's a slight difference with that. I mean, this is short term music. This is like, make the bucks now and get out. Because that's and I sincerely hope they do it, because they have got a very short lifespan. The Rolling Stones are different. I mean, 30 years on, they're still going. They're still selling 30,000 million pounds.
Who are these? Hold on a moment. These people next to you, sir, are they known to you? Because they seem to be shaking their heads.
Unfortunately, I think it's my wife and my two daughters.
Do you agree with them?
No.
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 What? I've heard the Rolling Stones for the whole of my life, and that's 17 years, and I can't stand them. I'm sorry, I can't stand them. I feel, yeah, that the Troggs and the Rolling Stones were the music of the 60s and 70s, and that type of music is the music for the 90s and maybe going on early into the 21st century. And that's going to be our music for our little era.
But a lot of people of your age actually do like the 60s music and 70s, but I think that's quite nice. I think we should appreciate the music of all the generations.
But, I mean, the Troggs, I'm probably doing Reg a disservice here, but I bet that when he started and he started playing Wild Thing, he thought he was in it for the quick bucks and out, and he never really thought that in 30 years' time they'd still be playing. But they have been, because they've got great talent.
I was starving to death.
So you got
trying to get that first
You
hit.
Got your quick bucks, and fantastic, and you're still playing, and that's really great. And I bet the Wedding Present, if they persevere, will do as well, because they've got some really great talent there.
Now, look. Forgive me if I'm revealing a family secret, but yeah. Actually you have a brother, Tim Rice, who writes lyrics.
Yes.
Yes? Mm-hmm. Now, you said to me, forgive me giving you away, that you couldn't hear the lyrics when they were singing. Now, if the lyrics are completely inaudible, doesn't that...
No, I had to listen carefully to make out the lyrics, and they were very good. They were actually quite romantic lyrics, rather like Love Is All Around. But it wasn't a romantic backing with it, which is a bit of a pity. But the point is that you get a song like Unchained Melody. When I was a kid, my parents thought that was the greatest song ever, and why didn't I like it? Then the Righteous Brothers recorded it, I thought it was the greatest song ever. Sure. So
And
now it's got another version, and we all listen to that one as well. Yeah, but the point is that it's
very popular.
It's very popular. It's selling by the bucketload. It's a
now,
song.
Now, why is that? Is it because it fills a need in the market?
It is a romantic song that spans the generations, and I bet that there are a lot of songs being written now that in 20, 30 years' time will still be played, and everybody will be saying, gosh, the 90s were the good old days.
Actually, the lyrics quite often aren't that important because it's the overall sound.
Sir?
Yeah, I'd just like to say, I think there's an undercurrent of patronisation, and basically, I think it's insulting for older people to say that the music that we listen to is just rubbish and just write it off, like this lady here.
I didn't say that. I love Simply Red. I said this particular...
Could you stand up, madam?
Sorry. This particular song...
Stay there. This is clearly...
I said this particular song. I have great respect for young musicians.
Yeah.
This particular song... I was asked about, and I think it really is bloody awful. But Simply Red is brilliant.
That's fair enough.
And a lot of young groups are great, but this is awful. Nothing, no disrespect to them personally.
She means
I think
that
he's
in
a
the
pleasant
nicest
guy.
Way. The
I mean,
nicest way.
I think
right.
They're nice guys, but that music you cannot understand.
Well, music is a subjective thing, yeah, but what I'm getting at is I think so many people who say the 60s was so good, you should have been there. We're not in the 60s now, it's the 90s. I mean, we all have our opinions about music. We're not going to just sit back and let older people
That's
rip
you.
Our music to shreds and say and dismiss it. You know?
That's
no,
you.
No, we're not. I'm just one in a million. I'm
yeah,
just my
but,
opinion,
but
and
I,
you're giving
I think
your opinion.
I think you can't help but, like, you have this kind of...
No, this particular song I do
yeah,
not like,
yeah,
I'll never like in a million years.
I'm talking generally.
Yes, sir.
Actually, this is an unfair example to give us because the Wedding Present are, in fact, using all the tools of the trade that have been around for years and years. There's nothing, not single beat or guitar chord or bass pattern that hasn't been used for 30 years that they did up there. That doesn't make it modern music. It's extremely modern music, and it's designed for young people. It is
right.
Definitely not designed for middle-aged and old people.
And like
therefore,
you and me?
Like you and me.
You like it?
Yes, actually, I think it has a lot of merit. I'd like to hear it a bit more clearly, I must say. I'd like, because I'm very interested in lyrics.
Because you write them.
No, in fact, my partner Doug writes lyrics.
Hello,
I write
how
tunes.
Do you do, Doug? How do you do? All right, now...
That's why he's interested in lyrics. Yeah.
And you are successful songwriters, no doubt.
Yes, we have yes, been over yes, the yes. last
writing
30,
for
30 years-ish.
Writing for people like...
Elvis Presley, Cliff Richard, yeah. Ray Charles,
heard
Tom
of them.
Jones.
Heard of them,
people.
Yes. Yeah. All right, yeah. So... Let us ask you, is there a difference now? When people say they don't write songs like they used to, is that true?
No, it isn't true. There are still a large number of very high-quality songs being written. If you look at the recent past, the Andy Hill, Pete Sinfield song, Think Twice for Celine Dion, absolutely brilliant song. Yeah.
Yes.
And people voted with their feet and bought it by the million.
Well, it is interesting. When you get a big romantic song, like Unchained Melody or, you know, the Bryan Adams hit, or indeed Reg's hit, you know, done over again by a new group. It sells for weeks and weeks. It's number one on the charts. That must mean something. It must mean that
well,
more people
mean,
like it.
It does mean, I think, the older audience swing into action and buy it rather than just kids.
I think it touches their emotions rather than just their feet. These are the songs that have very broad appeal.
So you
strong
you just,
romantic songs.
You just think it's the oldies coming out in their Zimmer
frame?
No,
I think it's everybody. I think it sells right across the
board. Well, yes.
I'm sure.
Yes, Reg.
Because a record may sell 350,000 today, but when the old people get off their feet, get on their feet and go out and buy, 1.7 million Love Is All Around sold. You know, it shows you that there's...
What was it like? Was it like winning the lottery?
I don't know. I'm still sort of waiting, you know. It takes about 3 years to filter in, you know.
You haven't got the money yet, but you...
Not quite, but it's yeah.
But when you saw it beginning to happen, what was it like?
No, it's not. I wasn't...
You won lots of friends.
Did it?
And I really wasn't thinking of the money either. It's strange, but I was doing fine. But all of a sudden, this has happened. It's great. It's
so
like
what's
a new...
But if it's not the money, what is it?
It's the software. Business. It's fabulous. I mean, the whole business is great. But it does make a point when only 350,000 people go out normally and buy records.
Yes.
And when there is something really good up there, they will all go out and buy it. So we should have a radio station that should, you know, give us all something to listen to instead of a certain section of people. Radio 1 does that. The other commercial stations are opening up and they've got a lot of listeners.
So you're blaming people like Dave over there,
well,
are you?
Yeah, to a point, but it's just...
Yes, go on.
Radio 1's made a commitment to play more new music than any other radio station. We believe passionately that there's so much talent in this country, and we don't necessarily think we're there just to play old songs.
No,
because we've got Radio 2. There's so many other stations there.
But not everybody wants to listen to old music.
We're there to champion new music. That's not our brief. We're there to champion new music, because just as you wanted to get your first break when you started out, we're trying to help lots of young new bands get their first
music. You're doing one segment of music.
Otherwise, there'd be no more music.
So are you saying you didn't play Love Is All Around when it got to number one? Are you saying Radio 1 said...
We played it. We played it on...
Thank you very much,
and you've got your royalty, so you should be happy. But don't slag off dance music.
Yes, you are. Sir, you're putting your hand up.
Well, we were talking about Love Is All... When did you write that one, Reg?
Ooh, 67.
Because you know that Take That wrote that this year as well. As a matter of interest, Take That were at number one for about 5 weeks with exactly the same song. If I can just...
Go on, prove it.
Right. I feel it in my fingers, I feel it in my toes. And then the Take That version was... I think it's time for me to give...
You're cheating. Is he cheating?
No, it's the same song.
Is it?
Very, very close.
Same chords, you're saying?
Yeah, same melody line, same measure, same chords.
Yes, but that's unfair, isn't it?
Well, of course it's not.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to make 2 points. Firstly, you're mostly talking about money in the music industry. I don't really find that relevant in the music I listen to. Secondly, I think the most important thing is advancement. You listen to the Wedding Presents 4 albums, they're all very different. You listen to Scott Walker, that lady says she loved, you know, the 60s music. She probably loved the Walker Brothers then. Have you heard his latest album? You'd probably absolutely despise it. It's advancement. You've got to bring yourself forward.
So you
you've got to listen to different
music
things.
Music is definitely getting better, you
it's
think?
It's definitely getting better with people like PJ Harvey, Suede, Gallon Drunk, Dean Mendicalars.
So you're saying that the Wedding Present is actually better than the Trogs?
No, not necessarily.
Well, you like
but
the style
better. It's all about advancing, about listening and learning and changing and moving on.
Yeah, yes, sir.
The majority of these bands can't hardly play music anyway, because they rely on electronics, computers, synthesizers, and everything else to bug them along on the end. I mean, there's cases where bands have been playing live and the tapes broke.
What do you think, madam?
Well, I find it very interesting. You've had things like Reg's Record and Unchained Melody. And it's very interesting that these big records tend to be supported by a big film, a big TV show, that kind of thing. You don't normally get a record selling absolutely millions like that, unless there's something to go along with it.
Hang on, let me come round. Yes.
When music becomes so mechanical, I just like to listen to my washing machine going round. It's the same thing. From the 40s and 50s, you know, when we were listening to old bands, we listened to people doing it from their heart. Now they're doing it going like that. How can...
Not the same. Yes, sir.
I think the trouble is that the music industry is in turmoil at the moment because all the old acts are still at the forefront. It's still your Pink Floyds and your Genesises that are making all the money and bringing out these big albums, even now.
Yeah, okay,
well, maybe they are good. But the record industry is to blame because they're not nurturing new talent like they used to do.
How many albums does Floyd sell?
Millions.
Why do they sell millions of albums?
Because they're a good turn. Yeah, but what I'm saying is, what the record industry needs is new talents to be nurtured in the same way as they were.
What do you buy?
I buy across the board. I buy all sorts of things. I might buy a Pink Floyd album. I might buy Oasis. But the thing is that now the record industry isn't giving people a chance. The bands come in, if they don't have a hit with their first record, then they're out of there. And the music press is to blame as well because they build people up and they knock them down before they've had a chance.
Haven't they always done that a bit?
Not to the extent they do now, no.
Right, sir?
I listen mainly to classical music, but on Saturdays I go to a second-hand record shop in Soho, and in the back room, sort of where much of the stuff is, it's actually next to either a girly bar or a strip bar, and they play this dance music with this tremendous beat. And it's music I'd never ever listened to at home, but I think it's absolutely great, and I sit there going through these classical records, sort of like, and it really lifts me, you know. I can be in there for hours, and it's great.
Can I just ask you to take me back to that story? You go to Soho, to the back rooms, and you listen to strippers.
No, well
this is unusual. Don't you think this is unusual?
Well, I actually thought that it was part of the shop, but they don't actually play any music in the shop, and I suddenly thought, Emily, where's this coming from? And there's always a scantily clad lady outside, and you go down, and it's definitely this place.
Right, and if you don't like the beat, you can always come out and look at the lady. Right, if you could actually take one record to a desert island, what would it be, sir?
I'd take an album by the brilliant XTC called Oranges and Lemons. Greatly underrated XTC. And can I just say about the wedding present, I'd like to actually defend them, even though I'm not a fan, because they might not be going out to make music for a mass appeal market, and I respect them for that, I think.
Well, let's ask them. Do you want to become popular across the board, have a great number one hit, or are you happy, you know, doing a number of records that perhaps less people buy each one, but they're still being bought?
I think it's not something we actually aim to do. I mean, we wouldn't sit down, I think in the same way as Reg, you know, I wouldn't sit down and think, we've got to write a number one single. Because you know, I think the minute you start writing songs for the people, whether it be your record company or your fans or TV or whatever, it's a slippery road down to, you know, at the end of the day, you could be selling cornflakes or cars or something. So what you've got to do is actually write music for yourself.
If you could take one record to a desert island, what would it be?
I think, what's that? Yeah, Chaz and Dave? Rabbit. Yep. Is that Rabbit?
You old romantic. Yes, what would you take?
Well, I'd take a Rolling Stones Midnight Rambler because of what it is. But
would not share the same desert island. No, what would you take?
I'm afraid I'd take Guns N' Roses song, You Could Be Mine, because it was the actual one that got me interested in that type of music.
Right, yes?
Even though I like take that today, my mum has done a good job of me liking Elvis Presley, and I think I'd take an Elvis Presley one.
Would you, Tony?
I'd take England Dan, John Ford Curley, Love Is the Answer. I think it's just a lovely song. It's always,
sing it, me.
Love is the answer. Bum, 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 bum. It's one I always play. It's one I always play if I get moved on, let's put it that way, from a radio station. It's always the last record I play.
Oh, isn't that sweet? Okay, what are you going to pick?
I think I'd take Kathy's Clown by the Everly Brothers. Fantastic record.
Oh, right. Tell us, Reg, what would you pick on a desert island, and it can't be something you've written?
It would have to be Guantelamera.
Oh, I love it. Guantelamera. All together.
Guantelamera.
Does any young person here know what we're talking about? Well, it's a well-known football song, I'm told. Well, listen, if you don't know what that song is, do please ask your parents. Thank you, everybody in the studio, for twisting and shouting with us. Sorry if you got no satisfaction, but thank you for joining us. And thank you for joining us at home. Till next time, we're going to leave you with the Troggs.